Okay, then let's have our Dhamma sermon. We are in Dhammapada, stanza number 145. Dandavagga, the last stanza. Udakang hi nayanti netika usukara namayanti tejanan. Dharung namayanti tachaka attanan damayanti subhata. We had a very similar stanza in Panditavagga. In this stanza, you can see only one difference in one word, but that word is very huge difference. But anyway, this is tensa. Udakanghi nayanti netika usukara namayanti tejanan darun namayanti tachaka attanandamayanti subhata. In these sentences, four sentences in this stanza, three of them are using to give some similes. What are those? Irrigators, udakanghi nayanti netika, means irrigators lead the waters. As you know, farmers, when they need to get water, using their irrigation system and technology, they're ready to get water where they want it to get water. They have skill for that. They are using technology for that. It's happening. It's not happening recently. Even in the long time ago in the world, we had this system. Irrigators lead the waters. Fletchers bend shafts. Fletchers blend shafts. People who are using irons, some kind of weapon, war, or some kind of different instruments using iron or similar material, they don't have that material in original place. But smoothing, they can make what they wanted to do with that. They are smoothing it and they are making that they need. And darun namayanti tachaka, carpenters bend the wood. Darun namayanti tachaka, carpenter bend the woods. As you know, we are using furniture. In our places where we are dwelling, we use so many different kind of furniture. All these furniture come from woods. When you go to a forest, you don't have furniture that we have in our places, dwelling places. Taking that woods, particularly trees, and cutting into different measurements and smoothing those things, they are making beautiful furniture to use in your dwelling place, use in your office, and do some other things. These all are the explaining about talent of that people, what kind of talent they have, what kind of skillfuls are them. All these are explaining their skillfulness, their talents. The last word is the connection with the Buddha's teaching. Last stanza is the connection. Attanam damayanti subhata. The Buddha summarized all these skill, talents that people have. Such a person has such a talent. Finally, Buddha summarized in everything, the virtuous control themselves, the virtuous control themselves. Attanam damayanti subbata. Virtuous, practicing, developing their spirituality, becoming a virtuous person, then that person can control themselves, himself. This is the very important thing. This is the connection. What does it mean? The virtuousness and controlling themselves. What does it mean? This is very important. Dear friends, the Buddha's teachings mainly focus to win yourself, not to win the world, not to achieve external goal. Buddha always giving us directions to achieve, develop internal goal, internal objects. What does it mean? Without looking at outside, turning back to yourself and see what is happening there. That's why the Buddha said, Imasming Byama Matte Kalebare Lokancha Loka Samudyancha Loka Nirodancha Loka Nirodagami Patipadancha Panyapemi. Using this length of body, I would like to explain the world, the origin of the world, the cause of the world, and the cessation of the world, the path to cessation. See, the Buddha advised us to think about yourself. Using this length of body, you can investigate the world, the cessation, the cause of the world, cessation of the world. Everything you can investigate yourself. That's why, as you know, Prince Yasa and his 60 friends were having a picnic with some girls. But when they having, during their picnic time period, those girls took their ornaments, valuable things, and then they went away. Then they were taking shower, they were having bath in the river, therefore they were not able to catch them. Then when they come out and then ready, they started to search them, looking for those girls. They started to go through different paths. Somehow, once they met the Buddha, Buddha was meditating there. They met the Buddha. And then they thought, okay, this is, we can get some support from this ascetic, better to ask from him. If he met any girls going through this road, they reached to Buddha and then they didn't know whether he's a Buddha or not. Then they asked, Venerable, did you see any ladies on this road? And then Buddha said directly to them, they were wise enough to understand the Buddha's word. Therefore, Buddha directly asked from them, what do you think? Investigating, looking for a girl, why you are not looking yourself? Looking at yourself. This word was kind of surprise for them. They were not able to talk beyond that. They were not able to continue their discussions. They completely, they settled. So then Buddha started to deliver Dhamma for them. Dear friends, in this virtuousness is like that. We can control ourselves. We should have that ability. That is the talent that we develop, that we should develop. Why? Nibbana is not something else. Nibbana is not somewhere else too. Nibbana is within us. We have to open our mind to gain concentration and wisdom. Gaining wisdom is the goal. Gaining wisdom is the path for the realization. So we are working for that. As a Buddhist follower, Buddhist practitioner, we are practicing day by day. What we are gaining, we are gaining insight, calmness, peace, happiness. Why? Concentration. When you are developing our concentration, as a result of that concentration, we can gain our happiness. It's happening. So, Buddha giving us these directions. Actually, there was an incident to give this, utter this stanza. That incident was Venerable Sariputta had a student who was namely Sukha. His name was Sukha because they were rich. He was coming from a rich family. When he came to his mother's womb, at that moment, their family was very successful. They were very happy. Because they were Venerable Sariputta's follower. And then at his birth, Venerable Sariputta was in there, in their place, dwelling place. They were asking from Venerable Sariputta, what kind of name would be good for him? Then through their explanation of their parents and family members, Venerable Sariputta suggested to put him, name him as a Sukha. Then he became Sukha. So, at the age of 7, he was decided to get ordination and then he ordained under the guidance of Venerable Sariputta. One day, he was having arms round with Venerable Sariputta. He had met farmers, irrigators who lead the waters. And also he met pledgers who were bending the slabs. And he met carpenters who were bending woods, who were sharpening woods. Seeing all these things, he started to talk all these things with Venerable Sariputta. And then Venerable Sariputta gave him good guidance. Okay, get this as your meditation object. Practice meditation. Then somehow with that advice, he was able to attain enlightenment. So Buddha used this opportunity to explain about virtuous, how virtuous can control themselves. Seeing things outside, taking those things as an example, to develop their energy, to develop their effort, to develop the right effort, and then they started to practice Dhamma. Practicing Dhamma, they able to control their self. Dear friends, what does it mean really? Controlling their self means. Controlling their self means, this is basically, as you know, now we have concept, this is me. What is the reality with this concept? Five aggregates, form, Rupa, Vedana, Sanya, Sankhara, Vinyana. Form, feeling, sensation, accumulations. Form is this physical body. In this physical body, you can see five bases. What are those? Ear, nose, tongue, and body. All these base and these base connecting the, I mean, overall we can get this all or connecting all these bases. Or this is body, the physical body. And then this physical body is functioning with the help of mentality. What are those? Vedana, sanya, sankhara, vijnana. Feeling, sensations, and accumulation, and consciousness. With the help of these four things, this form is functioning. Then we can say, here is a living being. Here is a living being. In this way, now you can see the mind or Vedana, Sanya, Sankara, Vijnana, all these feeling, sensation, accumulation, and consciousness, all these are together. All these things together, when we take it together, we can say this is the mentality. This is the mentality. Then we are living under the guidance of, under the influence of our mentality. So form is not the powerful things among these two things, mentality and materiality. Mentality is the most powerful things. That's why the Buddha advice, sabba papassa akaranam kusalasu pusampada sachitta pariyodhapanam. Control your mind, control your mentality, which is very important. Controlling mind is the teachings of the Buddha. As you know, you can see several philosophers, religious leaders in this world. No one were not talking about the controlling mind. Everybody basically talking about them in their word and action. Word and action. Because they pay attention to outside, not inside. But as you know with our experience, through our experiences, mind is the leader, mind is the forerunner. Whatever happening through our body, all these are the results of your mind. The results of your mind. Now you are listening to my talk because you get the invitation from your mind. If you are not getting any guidance from your mind, you are not ready to stay in this moment to listen to this Dhamma talk. Why? The body does not have any energy if you are not getting that energy from your mind. That's the reality. That is the reality. So there were so many conversations with the Buddha to explain about this power. Explain about this power. Chittena niyati loko chittena parikassati chittaseka dhammasa sabbhanga vasamangu. Chittena niyati loko. This world is going forward because of the mind, with the influence of the mind. Chittena parikassati, in this world you can see some changes. All these changes are happening according to the mind. According to the mind. Chittasa loka dhammasa. Chittasa eka dhammasa. Sabbanga vasamangagu. We all are living under the influence of the mind. Influence of the mind. Pay attention to the materials that we are using in this world. Nail to plane. All these materials are productions by human beings, created by human beings, nail to plane. Where the origin place of these materials? Someone else's mind. Plane is not something just create. The plan had in someone's mind and using that plan, they started, and then with the help of others, through the process, it was came to the stage that we have in today, in this world. This is not finished yet. There are so many research, re-research, and through those research and re-researchers, in future there might be different form, different facilities, different nature would be there. All these changes happening through the mind, Just take simple example, the light bulb that you are using. As you know, nowadays we are using LED bulb. LED bulb. But years ago, we did not have LED bulb. We had different kind of, and recently we removed CFL. Before that, there were some other kind of bulbs. But now see, the light is different. We can get different colors, very similar to sunlight. We have bulbs, light bulb, very similar. The lights very similar to sunlight. And also energy, consuming energy level is very low comparing with the previous ones. All these things happening in this world, how? With the influence of mind, Therefore, the virtuous control themselves, but very important word, virtuous. Virtuous mean who are in spiritual development. They are developed their mind to think deeply and vitally. This is the nature of spirituality. Virtuous person. Who is virtuous person? Person who can think deeply and vitally. That person not ready to depend in on conventional truth. That person ready to go beyond that conventional truth to absolute truth. Absolute truth and conventional truth are two difference. In conventionally, you know, in here, this monk is giving a talk. But absolutely, in here, only the process. This is the nature, this is the reality. All these things are happening with under the influence of three characteristics: impermanent, suffering, and selflessness. But no one can see that reality with your naked eye. You have to open and you have to develop your insight, develop your concentration. Then you can open your wisdom. Through wisdom, you can see this reality, the reality. But normally, generally, we are not in reality. Virtuous person means that kind of person who is open their mind. That person is the virtuous person. Now, being a virtuous person, he is ready to control himself. Why? Because he knows controlling himself, gaining concentration is the only path to open the mind to gain wisdom. Without achieving wisdom, there is no any results in the Buddha's dispensation. So we are trying to gain our wisdom through our practices, Therefore, take this example. All these examples are very familiar. Everyone might have experience with this. Irrigators, pledgers, and carpenters. All these people are so in their talent, unbelievable productions are there because of their talent. Now, using that as an example to develop our courage and energy, then why I can't gain my concentration? I can do that. Develop your energy, develop your courage, pay full attention, develop your effort. For what? To develop your skillfulness. To reduce your unskillfulness. Increase your skillfulness, reduce unskillfulness. So, seeing the world, seeing the reality, go beyond the conventional truth, we can get this path, we can practice this for our own liberation, for our own liberation. I think that would be enough for today. We are ending Dhammapada Dandavagga, then we are ready to start next one, Jaravagga, old age. So all these instances are giving us wonderful similes. Better to keep those similes with you all the time, then that would be very helpful for you to develop this Dhamma practice and also knowledge of the Dhamma, which is very important. Okay, then we can wind up today program. Thank you very much for your participation. Let us use this opportunity to share merits with others. Sharing merits also another meritorious deed. Patti patta anumodana among 10 kusala. One is patti patta anumodana. It means sharing merits with others. It is also one of meritorious deeds. Now think about our departed relatives, friends, family members, and pets. Who departed, name of us? Not recently, might be in few years ago, might be in our previous existence, it doesn't matter. Whoever is willing to get some support from us. By the power of these merits and metta thoughts, may they all rejoice these merits. May they be well in their sansaric journey. May they be able to attain ultimate bliss of Nibbana. Having that aspiration, say, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. Whoever is affected by COVID-19 and any other sicknesses, whoever is suffering from any kind of sicknesses, living with painful, sorrowful situations, by the power of these merits and metta thoughts, may they all be well, happy and peaceful. May they be able to get rid of their pain and sorrow. Having that aspiration, make blessings upon them, saying, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. Finally, think about yourself. By the power of all these merits and metta, may we all be well, happy and peaceful. Whatever the wishes you have, all your wishes come true by the power of these merits and metta thoughts. Developing our virtuosity, developing our insight, developing our mind, we are able to gain our wisdom, gain in our wisdom, to attain enlightenment. All these merits and metta thoughts get support, having that aspiration, say, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. By means of these meritorious deeds, may I never join with the police. May I join always with vice until the time attain Nibbana. May the suffering be free from suffering. May the fear struck be free from fear. May the grieving be free from grief. So too may all beings be, from the highest limbs of existence to the lowest. May all beings arisen in these realms with poem and without poem, with perception and without perception, be released from all suffering and attain to perfect peace. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Thank you very much. See you in
Thank you, Bhante.
Thank you, Bhante. Thank you, Brian.